That's part of the reason why we can say with such confidence that everyone who wants a vaccine in Canada will get one by the end of September.
Canada stays shut while other countries open up. It's all Justin Trudeau's fault. Hi, I'm Brian Lilly, political columnist with the Toronto Sun. I don't know if you saw this headline the other day. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu wants to open up his country by April. In Britain, Prime Minister Boris Johnson is saying by June, the Brits will be fully open. And here in Canada, well, the biggest city in the country, Toronto, has just canceled all events through until July.
The city is extending the cancellation of in-person, city-led and city-permitted outdoor major events from March 31st to July 1st, including in-person Canada Day parades, festivals and events.
And our federal Chief Medical Officer of Health, Dr. Theresa Tam, is saying that she hopes we can lift public health restrictions by September.
And September is a target, of course, for as many Canadians as who wants a vaccine getting vaccinated.
That means, think about that, that means we keep on wearing masks, we keep on going on with social distancing, we're not seeing family and friends. The concert you wanted to see in the summer, the festival you wanted to go to, Blue Jays opening day, your local CFL game, local sports, all of those things, your whole life still put on hold while other people get back to theirs. And it lays at the feet of Justin Trudeau for two brutal mistakes, one at the beginning of COVID-19 and one towards the back end. The one at the beginning, he didn't deal with the border seriously. The one at the back end, he didn't deal with vaccines seriously. Now, you know what it was like at the beginning of this pandemic. Justin Trudeau and the Liberals scoffed at the idea that they would ever impose border restrictions or even proper border screening.
In the beginnings, there was discussion of whether or not we should entirely close our borders to China the way the United States did. We did not. We were able to manage it in a way that allowed for control and a non-spread of the virus.
Now, at first, we were just dealing with one hotspot, Wuhan, in China. But they didn't want to do anything about that. They considered that racist. As the hotspots moved around the world to Iran, to Egypt, to Germany, to Italy, to the United States, they still didn't do anything until the middle of March. And it wasn't until the end of March, 2 months after COVID-19 had arrived in Canada, that they actually put in quarantine measures, something that should have happened in January. They failed from the very beginning. And that allowed COVID-19 to get into the country and spread. And once it was here, premiers have had to deal with it. But it was Justin Trudeau and his federal government that let this in to the degree and the scale that it's here. Now, the second mistake is not taking vaccines seriously. Trudeau obviously didn't think that this was something Canada needed to do. The Brits did, and they were out there from the beginning saying, we're going to make a vaccine here. We took the opposite route and said we couldn't possibly do it. Guess what? They're making vaccines, we're not. They started behind us in vaccine manufacturing capabilities. They're now ahead of us, and their people are going to be freer sooner. Sure, you could say that, well, lots of countries aren't doing very well. Really? Well, we're a G7 country, and right now we're 48th. By the end of March, we're promised that we will get 6 million doses of vaccines into arms. That's enough to vaccinate 3 million people, or 7.8% of the population. That would put us at 18th spot right now. Instead, we're at 48th. Because Trudeau didn't take the vaccine issue seriously. That means continuing to live this COVID lockdown hell that we've been living. I know that they're pumping their chest right now and saying, we're getting the biggest number of doses we've ever received, 643,000 doses this week alone. That is less than Joe Biden and the American Jews by lunch every single day. We are shamefully, shamefully inadequate in terms of vaccine supply in this country. And that's not on the provinces. That's not in a single premier. That is up to the federal government. They signed the contracts. They signed bad contracts. They got into the game late. They didn't pay premiums. They didn't look after manufacturing here. All the things that they could have done to get us ahead. Instead, we're at 48th. Explain to me why countries like Switzerland, the Maldives, Malta are ahead of Canada. We are a G7 country and we're at 48th. And Justin Trudeau and the Liberals think that's good enough. They're telling you that every Canadian that wants one will have one by September. That may yet happen. But if we are able to get vaccines quicker because processes speed up, because other vaccines are approved, guess what? That will happen in other countries as well. And they will still be out even sooner than we are. This is a failure on the part of the Prime Minister, and he should remember that, and you should make him and his government remember that every single day that you are dealing with lockdowns, curfews, stay-at-home orders, or restrictions of any kind.